Hi there, and welcome to the Country Music Time Machine. As we go back to 1974, covering the decades of country music history.
I have never been a quitter. Therefore, I shall resign the presidency effective at noon tomorrow. Vice President Ford will be sworn in as president at that hour in this office.
Be at the theater early because this man, I'm going to retire. If you think I whoop Sonny Liston, you wait till I get George Foreman. He talks too much, he's ugly, he's pretending I'm the true champion, and they make me the underdog. I'm going to show them all they're wrong because I'm the champion.
Yes, we were entertained in 74 with the Rumble in the Jungle with Ali versus Foreman. And of course, Muhammad Ali won, but he would not retire until 1981. Country purists were outraged when a pop diva won the Country Female Vocalist of the Year. Olivia Newton-John did have two number one country songs in 1974. Here they are.
I'm not trying to make you feel uncomfortable. I'm not trying to make you anything at all. But this feeling.
Me some Olivia Newton-John. She was my first crush as a young boy. The Grand Ole Opry moved from the Ryman Auditorium in 74 to the newly constructed Grand Ole Opry House on the Opryland complex. More controversy happened when Loretta Lynn releases The Pill, a sexually frank song about birth control.
The girls in New York City, they all march for women's lift. Better homes than garden shows, a modern way to live. The pill may change your world tomorrow, but for me, what today?
The song is deemed too controversial, and most country stations refuse to play it. Dolly Parton had number one hits with two of her signature songs. Some great future country stars were born in 74. Happy birthday to John Rich, Brian White, Jennifer Nettles of Sugarland, and Natalie Maines of the band formerly known as the Dixie Chicks. The man that had the most number one songs in 1974 on the country charts was Charlie Rich.
Baby, somewhere I know I'm gonna find it, baby. It'll have my love behind it, and it will be a symphony of all you mean to me, a very special love song.
Well, that was an amazing year in country music. We head to 1975 next, and we will fall off the mountain with Hank Jr. A Son of Mexican Immigrants hits the charts, and Glenn Campbell has his biggest hits. So don't go anywhere. We'll see you again in 1975.